I am Flash Isaac, and today I shall be taking you through John Blackley questions under electrolysis. Electrolysis is the passage of direct current through a compound in multi-state or in solution with decomposition occurring at the electrodes. Electrodes are the cathode and anode. For electrolytic cell, the anode is positive and the cathode is negative. Now, few days ago, I released a detailed video on electrolysis and I did a lot of calculation. If you are still having challenge in electrolysis, I highly recommend that video. I'll share a link to my electrolysis video so that you watch, understand, then come back to questions. If you watch that video, fine, let us proceed. So, jump past and likely questions under electrolysis. I shall be making use of the Flash Nellers Jump CBT app. The Flash Nellers Jump CBT app is the best and most advanced application to pass jump. It contains thousands of questions, all novels, jump recommended novels. In fact, you can watch my videos directly from the app. So go to Play Store, search Flash Nellers Jump app, or visit flashlearners.com to install one for yourself right now. My number is there. You can call me if you have any complaint on how to activate the application. I will as well share direct link to the below, so you just click and download the application. So let us begin. The first question here says, in the electrolysis of copper sulfate, CuSO4 aqueous, copper tetraoxosulfate cis aqueous, using platinum electrodes, the reaction at the anode is. Now look at this. What type of reaction take place in the anode? Cryo means cathode reduction. Anode oxidation. So reduction takes place in the cathode. Why oxidation takes place in the anode? What is oxidation? Oxidation is the addition of oxygen. What is oxidation? Oxidation is the removal of hydrogen. Reduction is the removal of oxygen. Reduction is the addition of hydrogen. Now, the main concern in electrolysis is loss or gain of electron, which means in electrolysis, talking about oxidation and reduction, we mean oxidation being loss of electron. And reduction meaning gain of electron. Now, electrolysis of copper sulfate, aqueous. What does aqueous mean? Anytime we are given a compound in chemistry with Aq below it, it simply means that that compound is in solution. In other words, it is dissolved in water. Now, if copper sulfate is dissolved in water, it simply means that we have copper sulfate and we have water. So, when water dissociates, what do we have? We simply have hydrogen ion and hydroxy ion. These are the ions present in water. However, copper sulfate, when copper sulfate dissociates, we have Cu, this will be 2 plus, and we have SO4, 2 minus. So, take a look at that. What next? Migration of the ions. I told you that in electrolytic cell, anode is positive and cathode is negative. Now we have two types of ions. Positive ions are called cations. So in this case, the cations are Cu2 plus and H plus. And the anions, which are negative ions, they are simply OH minus and SO42 minus. So we are the question says the reaction at the anode is, so the anode, the negative anode is positive, so the negative ions, they go to the anode, the anions, they go to the anode. So these are the two ions present in the anode. The anode has nothing to do with anything positive. So any option with anything plus is wrong, meaning option A is completely wrong. Look at something else. Now that these two have migrated, remember, platinum electrode is inert, so it doesn't take part in the reaction. Because in electrolysis, the nature of electrodes can affect the discharge. And the position in electrochemical series can affect the discharge. And electron concentration can affect the discharge. So the higher the concentration, the easier it is for that particular substance or ion to be discharged. But in this case, we are following the position in the electrochemical series. In that case, in the electrode, OH remains. This guy goes, OH is deposited, so giving us OH minus. So now that OH minus is preferentially discharged or is deposited, what now happens? And remember, the reaction at the anode is oxidation, which is loss of electron. So this OH minus loses electron to give you water, and oxygen is given off. So the balance equation is 4OH minus losing 4 electrons to give you 2H2O plus oxygen. Take a look at something. If you are given H, this is hydrogen atom. How about H plus? Hydrogen ion, which means this hydrogen atom has given off electron. What if it gains the electron back? It becomes an atom. How about chlorine? This is chlorine atom. What about this? Chlorine ion. When chlorine ion, this means chlorine has gained electron, it becomes negatively charged. So to get back to chlorine or to become chlorine back, it needs to lose electron, which is oxidation. So once this chlorine loses electron, it goes back to chlorine atom. So this guy losing electron, water molecule is formed, and oxygen bubble. So that is it. The conductivity of an electrolyte increases as its concentration dash. As concentration increases, conductivity reduces, like I explained earlier. So take note of this. Given that M is the mass of a substance deposited during electrolysis, M is mass, and Q is equals quantity of electricity. E is equals electrochemical equivalent, as you can see in the question. Now it says, then Faraday's first law can be written as dash. Wow. Faraday's first law of electrolysis states that the mass of a compound or of a substance deposited during electrolysis, mass, is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity. Now, we don't solve with proportionality. We simply introduce equality and a constant. So the constant is this electrochemical equivalent. Therefore, the mass deposited is equals KQ. Let's look at the option. It's equals KQ, where K is constant. But this time around, this constant is electrochemical equivalent, like I told you just now. So which means M is equals EQ. So option B is the correct option. And the next question says, which of the following substances will decompose when an electric current is passed through it? Now, electrolytes are substances or compounds that decompose when electric current is passed through them. Now, we have conductors. Conductors conduct without decomposition, without dissociation, without being in molten state. Copper wires, when they conduct, they don't decompose. But for electrolyte, for them to conduct, they have to convert in most either in molten state, or in solution. These are the two conditions for electrolysis or for electrolytes. Now it says which of the following substances will decompose when an electric current is passed through them. In other words, which of the following is an electrolyte? That is the question asked here. Which of the following is an electrolyte? So copper rod is obviously not an electrolyte. Copper is a conductor. Sucrose solution, methylated spirits, they are not electrolyte. So the only electrolyte here is tetraoxosulfate cis acid. If you didn't know before now, know now, H2SO4. So it dissociates or decomposes or conducts electricity in molten state. So option C is the correct option. And this question says, the number of moles of copper 2 plus, what number of moles of copper 2 ion will be deposited by 360 coulombs of electricity, given that 1 farad is 96500 Cu2+. The charge is 2. So Q is equals 2. What does this charge mean? It simply means that since the charge on copper is 2, we will need 2 farad to deposit 1 mole of copper. That is the interpretation. If I give you, let's say, something like this, Fe3+, I'm giving an example. This one simply means you will need 3 farad, 3 electricity, to give 1 mole of iron. That is what this implies. So since this charge is 2, we need 2 farad to deposit 1 mole of copper. The question now says that, what number of moles will be deposited by a 360 coulomb? 360 is another charge. So if we need 2 farad to deposit 1 mole, then to deposit 360 coulomb, we simply need S. So 360 coulomb, we deposit S mole. Let us expand this. 2 times F, 96500. So 2 times 96500 will give 1 mole of C of copper. So 360 coulomb, let it be S. To get S, we cross multiply. Cross multiplying, we simply have that S is equals 360 over 2 times 96500, which is 360 times 1. So that is it. The answer you will get is in mole. That should give you 1.87 times 10 to the power of minus 3 mole, which is option B. This is a similar question. Now, this question requires reasoning and understanding. It says, calculate the amount of copper in moles that will be deposited by passing 3 faradays of electricity through a solution of copper 2 salt. Now, we know copper is Cu2+, right? So, naturally, we need 2 farad to give 1 mole of copper, right? So, the question is saying that, how many will be deposited by passing 3 farads? 2 farad deposits 1 mole normally. So, 3 farads will deposit, let's say, S mole. Simply mean we don't know. So, to know S, we cross multiply. S times 2 farad is simply 3 farad times 1. So, S is equals 3 farad times 1 is 3 farad over 2 farad. That is simply 3 over 2. That is the answer. It requires wisdom. And 3 over 2, is that 1.5? Yes. Is that option D? Yes. You move. What current will deposit 3.25 grams of zinc in 2 hours? Given that the mass of zinc is 65 grams per mole, which is the molar mass of zinc, and 1 farad is 96500 coulomb per mole. Now take a look at this. Anytime you see a calculation question, like major calculation question under electrolysis, this is the formula you will use. You don't need to analyze or cram, just substitute into this formula and you get your answer direct. After everything, thank me, send me money, okay? So look at it. This is the almighty formula for electrolysis. M, small m, is equals MIT over QF. What is M? Mass, not molar mass, mass. What is capital M? Molar mass. What is I? Current. What is T? Time. High bar Q, charge on the ion. If I give you Cu2+, the charge on the ion is 2. So that is it. And F is Faraday's constant or farads. Now this question says, what current we deposit? What current simply means we are looking for current. True or true? True. 3.25 grams. That is what? Mass. So small m is equals 3.25 grams of zinc in 2 hours. What is 2 hours? Time. So T is equals 2. And zinc, the molar mass of zinc, M is equals 65. And F is 96500. Q is 2, which is charge on zinc, because we are dealing with zinc. Substituting or making I subject formula, from here, M is equals MIT over QF. Cross multiplying, we have M times QF, MQF is equals MIT. Dividing both sides by MT, this cancels this, this cancels this, I will be left. So I is equals small m qf over mt. So let's substitute. Current becomes mass 3.25 times the charge is this 2, the charge on the zinc. So 2 times 96500 all over molar mass of zinc 65 times time is 7200. This will give you 1.34. I guessed 1.34 ampere. That is the answer. The acid used in electrolysis of water is dilute dash. Electrolysis of water is simply the decomposition of water into oxygen gas and hydrogen gas. And the electrolysis that is used is H2SO4, which further confirms that H2SO4 is an electrolyte. And the next question says that in the electrolysis of concentrated solution of sodium chloride using inert electrodes, concentrated sodium chloride is also referred to as brine. Using inert electrodes simply means that the electrodes don't partake in the reaction, in the electrolysis. It says which of the following ions are discharged at the cathode and anode respectively. Now, when you are reading questions, take note of keywords. It says concentrated solution. Then solution. Now, concentrated solution simply means that we have more sodium chloride than we have water. So it means we have less water, but there is water. Now, concentrated sodium chloride simply means that in this type of question, concentration will play a role. Factors which determine the preferential discharge of ions in electrolysis are: one, position in electrochemical series. The ones lower will be preferentially discharged. Two, concentration. The higher the concentration, the easier it is for it to be discharged, especially when they are closer in the series. For example, given Cl minus and OH minus, normally this OH minus is supposed to be preferentially discharged because it is lower in electrochemical series. Now, if it is a concentrated solution of sodium chloride, conc sodium chloride, this guy will be discharged instead of this, not because it is lower in the series, but because it is more concentrated than this guy. So that is where concentration play roles. And another thing is nature of electrode. Look at this. It says using inert electrodes. This simply means that the electrodes used are not reactive, so they will not take part in the reaction. Now, what if in this reaction or in this electrolysis, mercury is used? If mercury is used in electrolysis of concentrated sodium chloride, the nature of electrode will play a role. Look at this. Sodium, Na, and H. Normally, hydrogen will be preferentially discharged because it is lower in the electrochemical series. But if we use mercury electrode, hydrogen will not be discharged. Instead, sodium will be discharged. What will happen and why? Sodium will be discharged because mercury has love for sodium. It has affinity for sodium. It will form sodium amalgam. Please replay this and listen all over again. So I will ask this question in three ways. One, electrolysis of concentrated sodium chloride using mercury electrode. What will happen? Sodium will be deposited at the cathode, and at the anode, you have Cl minus and OH minus. Because the concentration of chlorine is high, because of concentration, chlorine will be deposited, which means OH minus and H will be remaining to form water. So water will be remaining in the vessel. Number two question, electrolysis of concentrated sodium chloride using inert electrode, meaning electrodes are not taking place, they are not taking part in the reaction, but it is still concentrated. What will happen? Chlorine will be deposited or discharged at the anode. Why? Because of concentration, not because it is lower in the series. How about at the cathode? Hydrogen will be deposited. Now look at it. Fine, there is concentration, but because sodium and hydrogen they are far apart in the series, concentration will not take effect. So the distance is very far. Concentration always only happens when they are close in the series. Therefore, H plus will be discharged, which in the case of this question, option D is correct. Now, what if they had said dilute sodium chloride? Dilute. For dilute sodium chloride, here at the anode, this guy will be discharged instead of chlorine. So we have OH minus be deposited, and at the cathode, H plus will be deposited. So that is it for electrolysis. Jam likely questions. I hope you found this class helpful. Thank you and have a wonderful day.